Anya, you know me. You know that I try to look at things from both sides of the coin. You know that I'm not just trying to condemn that man, Owen Benjamin. But, like, how much is too... How many times can you go back and forth and flip-flop on shit? I'm listening to him talk and find and address Nightwave and say, you know what, guys? I thought these guys, Nightwave, were like George Soros bots or some whatever his bullshit, how he talks. George Soros, blah, blah, blah. So that's why I put a copyright strike on him. But just a day ago, you said you didn't put the copyright strike on him. It was Dolev. And she put it on him. So you basically used this Israeli Jewish broad to cover for you raging out and doing something so gay. You understand how gay that is to put a copyright strike on someone on you? I don't think people understand what that is. That's like you can't beat them with words and you can't just defend whatever their accusations are and move on and be like, you know, if somebody said something to me, like they were talking shit about me on Nightwave, I'd be like, okay, you know, but maybe, you know what I would do first off? I'd be like, these guys are pieces of shit, but, you know, let's listen to what they have to say. Maybe some criticism could help me improve myself. I know it's very hard to look ourselves in the mirror, but Owen Benjamin is incapable of doing that. When I get criticized, for some reason, There'll be a point in that time where I'll realize this person is just trying to be a jagoff, but at the same time, does any of it ring a bell? Is any of it true? Because they're trying to pick at you, at your faults. So if there's something they're saying, why don't you, you know, like when your mother tells you this or that, or your father tells you this or that, instead of being a spoiled little brat kid and being like, saying like, oh, whatever, like, you know, you see kids do, you gotta fucking realize that they're saying something to you for a reason. And men sharpen men, just like in the Bible. Men sharpen men like iron sharpen iron. And that's the problem I had with Owen. I told him some things about his comedy, and he's, how dare anybody speak to him that way? How dare I speak to him that way with a cult? And they really are a fucking cult. And I've realized the dynamic of, you know, it's like kind of like a case study for me, this Owen Benjamin's saga. It's a case study in human behavior. When there's a group of people clamoring for the attention of a person or a personality, a cult of personality, and he's making himself available on YouTube, but there's too many people for him to really respond to everybody, then the other people, the new people who show up, who are fresh with Owen Benjamin, they haven't been pissed off or thought this guy's retarded 90,000 times by now. They just started listening to him. They eat up everything he says and they clamor for attention even harder than those who have been there for a while. Like, you know, I talked to him a bunch of times in the beginning. He used to respond, play music I told him to play, you know, sing songs, take requests from me. And then I noticed new people coming in and they were like paying him to play songs. Shit he did for me for free. And I was like, what the fuck? They're paying him $20, $50 to play a little bullshit song that you could YouTube for free? Like, it was really hard for me to understand at first. And then his ego got bigger and bigger to the point where my shit talk that was okay in the beginning with him was no longer welcomed. He couldn't have me talking shit to him like he was a human being in front of his fucking cult. He needed only people that were gonna be like agreeing with him. And he started to, he didn't ban anybody until the one day where I was, his stream was lagging a little bit. And I was like, buddy, your fucking leftist fitness bit wasn't good. And I made him freak out. Turn the fucking live off, come back with his wife. You know, I have the videos, these bears that got mine. His wife's like, oh, why'd you ban him? I know I said this story before. I'm sorry, but it's just part of the saga. And now we're at a point where he's copyright striking people. That's what SJWs do. And just like the hypocrisy of me telling them, how are you going to ban me when you cry about Twitter banning you? It's the same thing. You talk about Joe Rogan all day. You talk shit. But when they talk shit about you, you copyright strike them? If Joe Rogan copyright striked Owen, he would lose his mind and say it was the worst thing a person could ever do because it was towards him. But since it's him doing it towards them, and then he can't even have the balls to admit until now, I guess, that it wasn't Doev. He said it was, he blamed it on a female. He used her as a fucking, a shield. There was bullets flying at him, and he grabbed her around the neck, put her in a headlock, and fucking used her body to absorb the fucking blows. You know what I mean? You don't do that with women, bro. You take your fucking lumps, and he can't take them. And I see signs of, you know, I know people like this in my family. I know people who can't, who do these mental, these lies, dude. It's just, it's lies. And how can you sit there after somebody lied so many times and give them fucking slack, cut them slack? I can't no more. No, I don't even watch the shows because they're so boring, and it seems psychopathic when he plays the same skit three times. The same skit. Not like Leftist Fitness 1, 2, and 3. Like, he'll literally play Leftist Fitness 1 three times in a row and stroke his ego. He played that thing about his brother saying a beard. This isn't a beard. What was it, Anya? Anya. This isn't a beard and a mustache. This is a mustache that took over. He's like, guys, you want to watch my brother again? These people are paying $5 a week or whatever it is to watch you play the same clips. You know? And then he'll use his wife as a shield too. It's fucked up, man. When things are going bad, he always brings her on, man, to remind us he has a family and blah, blah, blah. But Nightwave, man, you guys might want to just get away from him. I don't know, man. They've brought Nightwave and them a lot up. But I actually don't even like talking about it no more because it seems like I'm talking about a crazy person. But he's not crazy. He's just fucked up, man. So it's kind of like a sad day for me. It's kind of like a sad thing to see somebody who had all them, you know, and to see all these people looking up to somebody who's not truthful. But I think I'm done talking about it from here. I wish everybody the best. Owen Benjamin included, Nightwave. You know, I don't like talking shit, but it's gotten to the point where it's like, it's not even fun anymore. Dude's just lying. He's doing shit that's horrible, like copyright striking people. That's horrible gay shit, man. That's leftist tactics. You're supposed to win with your words. Your ideas, man. You gotta stand on your feet like a man. You don't fucking claim some girl did something copyright strike when it was you. And you don't copyright strike somebody on YouTube. So, you know, I could go on forever here, but it is what it is, man. And it's just weak as all hell. So it's kind of, I'm kind of disgusted at this point with the whole thing. Like, what else is there to, like, even how lower can you go? Your boy who is like your best friend went as low as anybody could possibly go. Like, fucking saying he was in the Marines. The fact that you surround yourself like that and that guy's around your family, that shows you your judge of character. And I think Owen will only allow types of people like that Eric Nimmer guy around him. The type of people that are gonna play to his ego. The type of people that aren't gonna fucking, you know, try and like, what we call it here in Chicago is a pull up. And it basically was like pull up your pants, but it was anything. You would pull up your buddy on hygiene. You would pull up your buddy on this, that, or the other. Hey, buddy, I'm trying to give you a pull up. I'm trying to let you know, you need to tighten up in this specific situation or category, or just, you can't be walking around with them shoes on, bro. You need to, and then you know what you say? You know what, bro? You're right. Pull up, accept it. I was wrong, and pull up, accept it. And that's kind of like a warning, like, you're fucking up. Don't do it again. And if you can't be the type of person to accept the pull up from another man, you tell him right then and there, don't be fucking pulling me up on no bullshit. But if the pull up is valid, you'll be a man and you accept that fucking pull up. But no, Owen Benjamin's never been around men like that, I don't think. Where he's had men look at him and say, hey, you're acting like a little fucking bitch, bro. Or he's never had anybody punch him in the chest and knock him on the ground and then reach down and grab his hand and pull him back up. You know, sometimes if we start to act like a little bitch, we need to be punched in the chest and that air knocked out of us and then pulled back up and say, hey, you want to fight? Oh, no? Okay, well, then stop doing what you're doing. I could fucking kill you right now. I'm not going to, though, because I like you. And I see that you can actually, you know, grow from this. You know, I've been punched in the chest. I've punched people in the chest. I've slapped people. You know, people need that. And I don't think Owen's really had enough of that in his life. You know, violence isn't always a bad thing. You know, the threat of violence makes us very respectful. I think there's a lack of threat of violence in this, especially in like Los Angeles where he was for a decade. Those people just call the cops on people or are threatened to. You know, when you're in certain circles, I'm sure there's a lot of violence in Los Angeles. But like when you're in the, you know, Hollywood type of shit, you know? And another thing too, like how can these people sit there and watch him say, Joe Rogan, yeah, he's Toe Rogan, he lives in a shoebox, over and over talk about Joe Rogan, but then get, on the other hand, it's so hypocritical, get mad about these Nightwave guys, who Nightwave, you know, they've got their popularity is much bigger because of Owen now, you know, and all the dumb shit he's done. Like, people just have been tuning into them because of Owen. You know, they know who those guys are because of Owen. And, you know, the same cannot be said really about Joe Rogan. Like, you know, Owen talks shit about Joe Rogan, but then when they call him on this or that, and you know what? Owen's trying to wave the white flag, like, yeah, guys, Mersh, I don't even know your name, Nightwave guys, yeah, I'll take off the copyright strike, and he said it's so fake. Like, he still has the copyright strike on them right now. He's like, I don't believe that you can't stream. Well, you didn't even find out. Then he says he thinks they were from Soros, and that's why he put the copyright strike on them. You didn't think George Soros sent them after you, and that was your deciding factor on whether or not to hit a copyright strike. You couldn't handle them criticizing you. Stop lying. Don't lie like they were sent from Soros. You're not that fucking important, dude. And he's not even, like, joking about this shit. It's psycho. It's psychopath shit. You know? You can't take it. That's why he banned me. I've been banned from that man's channel for 7 months. Before anybody even really knew about who the fuck this guy was, I had been banned, been unbanned, and been rebanned. And changed my account and had that one banned. Because it was so much fun fucking with these people. Because it was like literally it was like literally being able to fuck with like Scientologists or something. Like Scientology had a live and a cult. And he was like, and Owen's L. Ron Hubbard, and I get to come in and tease them. So he waved the white flag, and you know what? Hold on 1 second, Anya. You know what they were saying? Nightwave were saying? They were telling Owen Benjamin that they believe Owen Benjamin was fucking Dolev. And Owen Benjamin's been cheating on his wife. And that's why he had to take care of Nimmer. Because Nimmer knew. And Nimmer knew his secrets. So he had to give Nimmer $3,500 for brain cancer. It wasn't fucking, you know, they really, really think this guy cheated on his wife. And Owen, if people are saying that type of shit about you, you gotta fucking address, I don't know, You can't wave a white flag and act like everything's just normal and okay. Owen wants them to stop talking about him so bad, but everything his dumb ass does, he's so slow. He doesn't understand human emotion. You know, I thought I was a little autistic. That man is fucking slow. Everything he does makes you want to talk about how stupid he is more. And be like, look at this jackass. And that's like the opposite of what he wants. So he wants him to stop talking about him. So what does he do? The worst thing you could ever do, copyright strike. What were you going to say, Anya?
Nothing.
And they're talking about you fucked your, you cheated on your wife, bro. And he brings his wife on to save him all the time. I don't know, man. It's just, this might be my last video about Owen Benjamin, because I don't want to, you know, I'll let them boys over there at Nightwave take care of that, and I'll let them people do that, but, you know, I actually really thought Owen was, like, at one point, all right, just, you know, this and that, but I've realized that, you know, he hasn't had a lot of males around him. He hasn't. That's why he's always looking up to people like Jordan Peterson. I don't know what happened with the boy, but he didn't get his ass beat enough as a child or something. You know, and you know, I'm not perfect. I probably could have got my ass beat a little bit more. But, you know, at least I got my ass beat a little bit. It appears that Owen has not realized. He doesn't have the fear of pain. He doesn't have the fear to shut his fucking mouth. And he sits there and says Joe Rogan can beat his ass, but he keeps on talking shit. So that means you're talking shit about somebody. That's like me talking about shit about somebody like Mike Tyson. I know he can whip my ass, but I'm going to still talk shit. So why am I talking shit about somebody I know can whip my ass like he says about Rogan? Because I don't think he's ever going to get the opportunity. Because in this world, you get to run your mouth and then never fucking put your money where your mouth is. You hide from the person. So that's fucked up. That's it for now, man. This has got to be, I don't know. I'll probably make more videos, but it's just fucked up. It's kind of sad.